Welcome back to Let's Play The Wolf Among Us. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and now the stunning conclusion. Episode 5, Cry Wolf. So excited.
I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
That's a gray area.
Not if I can avoid it. No.
Holly's sister, Lily.
Yeah, both two victims there.
I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit.
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree. No!
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Yeah, I decided not to burn it.
You're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
I don't know. Snow will come around. She's just... You know, the crane thing hit her hard, and she doesn't really know who her friends are right now.
Oh, God, Bigby!
Yeah, I hurt.
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Bigby, wait. When you get the crooked man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
So, just like in Vampire the Masquerade, we're not supposed to be showing off our animal or monster selves. So, just as Mr. Toad should probably go to the farm, because he doesn't have money for the glamours, as well as Colin, we're breaking the, they don't call it this, but we're breaking the masquerade whenever we turn into wolf form to fight these people. So we could very well be sent to the farm as well. Something I actually did not realize until just now, looking at this flashbacks. Yeah, there has a point to it. Episode 5, Cry Wolf.
You've come a long way.
Yeah. Been around.
You must be tired.
Crooked Man's Lair. Night. Some church. One of many random places.
Are correct. You haven't had a lot of rest recently. Please, Sheriff. Relax for a moment, will you?
That's hard to do here.
Do you want a drink? Something to eat?
We're in the,
Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
We're in the wolf's den.
Well,
Ramasi me. I'm here for one reason.
At the very least.
I'm here for one reason, and it's not to eat your fucking food.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey.
Oh, he's got silver bullets, too.
Well, Sheriff.
Trigger
for
happy.
For the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You killed those women.
You know why I'm here. You killed those women.
What women?
Faith and Lily, the girls who worked at the pudding and pie.
Did I now? I assume by your confidence in accusing me, you must have some proof of this, yes? Some allotment of evidence. A witness, perhaps.
Did Jersey tell me?
Hmm?
I know you did it.
I know you did it.
I don't know if Jersey said so.
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I wish you had me dead to rights. I really do, for your own sake.
Yeah, I should have put
but
that.
No, I didn't kill anyone.
Not personally.
I don't relish telling you that the killings were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with. You really don't need to worry yourself further.
Who did it?
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him.
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information.
Well, that's a problem.
You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation?
Yes.
The man said he'd take care of it.
Negotiation.
So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm the law here.
I'm the law here, not you. Now tell me who did it.
You think I'm scared of you?
Should be.
You're nothing more
than a... That's enough.
I almost killed one of you.
I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie.
What alliance?
However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
He's not denying
Georgie,
it either.
Georgie,
you got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what? You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belonged.
Why'd you do it?
Georgie.
Why'd you do it? Why kill them?
Does it matter?
Look,
yes.
The fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
Which one's the liar?
Bollocks, sis! You're just gonna let him do this?
I bet you he did tell him
to
kill them.
Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
Take this fucker. Take all of them. I didn't fucking start this.
Don't make any trouble, Georgie.
Are you seriously throwing me under the fucking carriage?
I'll take
everything
both
I've done
of you.
For you.
I think I'll be taking both of you.
You're not taking me, you fucking ponce. What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I'll give a fuck
if I'm she's the part of it too.
Who the shit do you think you fuckers
are?
Get
the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
Yeah, what the fuck? You're gonna make sure we all go down this shitter with you?
I told you.
I already told you. I'm taking both of you in, so let's go.
This could have gone so well.
Doubtful.
To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Oh, it's Bloody Mary coming through the mirror. I didn't call your name 5 times.
Did I miss anything good? Well, look at you all fixed up.
Ow. Oof. Evade that. Too many. Yeah, too many.
Take this!
Oh, you broke the portal.
You're done, Wolf.
Broke through the portal.
We're pretty much done here.
Oh! Doesn't matter who
I'd
got.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you, but I'll be glad to see your insides turned out.
That's not gonna be happening. Now I gotta grapple with you. Ooh! Oh, that doesn't look good.
Oh, God.
This way.
Rematch. I beat your butt last time. I'll beat it again. Break the other antler off this time. Yeah, no such luck, I guess. I guess I'm going after him.
Come on, Dorothy.
Oh, shit!
I know.
Back in.
I know.
I'm coming for you. Oh, wow. How strong is he, right? Oh, damn it. What is this on the bottom? Am I supposed to be interacting with that somehow? Ow. That's the first quick time event I've missed in the whole freaking game. I'm not supposed to be doing something, right? The arrows are pointing in. It's actually really distracting. I'm gonna guess it's just a time indicator and just ignore it. Glance at it now and then, I guess. W? Got him.
Fuck! What was that?
Question is, who was that? Oh, damn it. Not by the hair of my QQQ. Oh, crap. Ow.
Got it.
Are you sure?
Do
no.
it.
He's not moving.
Keep going.
I thought you were a nice lady. The meter's gone now.
Oh, fuck. Oh,
come on.
Christ. Fuck it.
Well, no surprise where they went. Is there another way in? Definitely not in there. Blood.
Holy shit.
That's a lot of blood. There is another way I see in the back, but I could not take that, I guess.
Come on! We can't stay here!
Hang on! I need a minute.
Okay.
Are you peeping through the doorway?
How did this happen, Georgie? How did it get this?
Fuck. Well, it won't be your fault.
I don't know if I should have listened, or I don't want him to get away, so. Doesn't look like he's going anywhere, though.
Shit. Hello, Bigby. I hoped you'd come to your senses.
I don't have any sense. Just dollars.
But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
You're coming with me.
Had to say goodbyes first.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You gonna carry me?
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian, you don't know what you're doing.
I'm trying to help
you here. I'll
arrest
you too.
Just leave it alone.
I'll arrest you too if I have to.
Go ahead.
Okay.
It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer.
Let's remain silent.
Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
Mistakes?
What? He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then?
I
you
didn't
fucking...
mean...
Ah!
Of course it's
You're
your fault.
You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck?
Well, yeah, he was ordered to do
it. I did what I had to!
I do believe that.
You can't fucking blame me for that.
Look, I'm
sometimes
just...
you just have to do what you're told. Then
why
it
did you
back
do
to
it?
Bite you in the ass because some good-for-nothing crooked bastard decides you're not worth shit anymore.
Why'd you do it then, huh? If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the crooked man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it.
So two are trying to get away.
You don't know what that means. Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. The crooked man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out. The both of you can go rot in hell.
Georgie.
You think I'm the one to fucking blame?
That's not what I meant.
You're still responsible.
I know what you were trying to do.
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through with it.
Fine. Believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not. Go ahead and arrest me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing.
You won't be alone.
It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him. Coming here, talking about options. Like it was that simple.
Could've let him go.
You could've done anything else. You could've let them go. You could've freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die. Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
I told you, you don't know the fuck about anything.
What do you mean?
What are you talking about?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
I know
those
that.
Those were your ribbons?
But did it have to be like this?
Wait. Those were your ribbons? You're in on this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand, nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were going to be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the crooked man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell! Save the fucking day!
Stop it!
I told you, sometimes all your options are shit. What the fuck are you supposed to do then?
We'll find another way. She doesn't have to die. Maybe the witches can...
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience.
She's gonna
Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
I wasn't really...
Just
not
shut
doing
up.
It.
Vivian, I'm not gonna kill you.
I know that.
She's
Wait.
Gonna pull it.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just... do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait.
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them. What I took away from them. I look at Nerissa... and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian, don't!
Vivian!
No! Fuck! No, 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 no! Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian!
Yeah.
Shit!
I'm just gonna be quiet.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just...
You gonna die now? Wow.
Oh, fuck!
Get up. Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the crooked man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us. You know the bastard deserves it.
Don't worry about
make
him.
A promise to a dying man. Give him help.
I actually can.
Don't worry about the crooked man.
Old foundry by the river. All right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you wanna do, right? Well, whatever it is, just get it over with.
That's not who I am.
I'm not sticking around for much longer.
That's not who I am.
Prove it, then. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends.
Does he want a mercy killing?
Just make it quick.
Yeah.
I know what I did.
It's a mercy killing, right? It's a good thing we're
Let's
doing.
Let's not draw this out.
All right, he wants it, so.
All right, Georgie.
Chose to end Georgie's suffering. At least got him in the heart instead. God damn. I thought these fables, well, at least Georgie died, would not die as easily. You see everything the others go through and they're still alive. That was rough. I didn't specifically care for either of the two characters. Well, she was cool. I didn't know much about her, so I wasn't really, you know, invested in the character. He was a jerk, but still. That was rough. Vivian's story, the girl with the ribbon. Vivian was the first to bear the curse of the purple ribbon. Removing the ribbon would result in death, and any attempt to talk about it was thwarted by the spell upon it. As time went on, she tried to live a normal life. Eventually, she married a nice man, but he was constantly wondering about the ribbon around her neck. Despite her pleas for him to leave it alone, one night while she was sleeping, he attempted to remove it. As he pulled on the edge of the string, Vivian woke and saw what her husband was doing. In a panic, she pulled away, preventing the ribbon's knot from being undone. Furious, she tried to express the severity of his actions, but her husband was unable to understand. She realized then that she couldn't trust him and decided to leave. She lived alone for the rest of her days in the homelands, preferring the safety of isolation to the risk of another betrayal. The Pudding and Pie. Vivian and Georgie's place. Vivian and Georgie met during the exodus from the homelands, and they helped each other survive the long journey to the mundane world. Upon their arrival, however, they found it hard to make a decent living. With what little money they had, they opened the Pudding and Pie. Operating a strip club may not have been the most desirable occupation, but they figured it was better to be in charge of a place like this than be forced to work, than be forced to desperation to work at one. Okay. And thus the end of these two. I'm afraid this place is going to be closing up now. We're going to find the Crooked Man. I don't know if we're going to ever rematch with the Jersey Devil again, and Tweedledee, Tweedledum again, and Bloody Mary. I'm hoping I can show her a thing or two. I really do not like her, but I don't think you're supposed to like her. This is the Metalworks place, then. Shepherd Metalworks, late night, limousine.
Still warm. He's here, all right.
I wonder if he's going to be expecting us like last time. Anything else to look at? Or we're just going in the door? I guess we're just going in the door then.
Of course.
Busted. Watch out for those silver bullets.